We are expecting more and more this kind of event where non-Muslim come to here to learn about Islam. So we want to train more volunteers. So if anyone who speaks Chinese and Muslims, they want to volunteer, they can come and we will train and how to share Islam to the visitors of this mosque and the Chinese mosque.
Asli, ini jarang banget terjadi di sini. Ini gila sih, guys. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jumpa lagi dengan saya, guys, Cak Mujib. Gimana kabar teman-teman semua? Semoga sehat selalu dalam lindungan Allah Subhanahu wa taala, dijauhkan dari segala mara bahaya, malapetaka bencana dan bala serta berbagai macam penyakit. Amin amin ya rabbal alamin. Alright, guys, kali ini kita akan reaksi sebuah video. Wow, video kali ini nih sangat-sangat menakjubkan sekali dan sangat-sangat menarik. Jadi saya harap teman-teman tidak melewatkan video kali ini. Langsung tengok videonya. Dan juga guys, jangan lupa tonton sampai selesai, karena banyak pesan dan hal-hal penting yang disampaikan. Dan ini hal baru di Malaysia, dan mungkin satu-satunya tempat yang mempunyai culture yang berbeda gitu kan. Nah, tanpa berlama-lama, jom kita simak videonya, guys. Let's go.
Chinese Muslim Masjid in Malaysia. Wow. Assalamualaikum. Today we are in Klang visiting a Chinese Muslim Masjid just built recently. And this is our brother Rizwan. He's the first Chinese Malaysian Muslim that I met in person. He's also doing the content about Islam.
Okay.
Later, we're gonna have small conversation about his journey to Islam and his restaurant. But before that, let's start the masjid tour. Oh, this is the Zhou Bi. Wow, it's really Chinese traditional thing.
And this is the last sermon of Nabi Muhammad.
Oh, yeah.
And this is my friend, Shafiq.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Welcome, welcome.
He can speak fluent Chinese.
Masjid Jami China Muslim Klang. So it's like Chinese Muslim of the Klang Chinese Muslim Mosque. So Masjid Jami. So in Malaysia we have different Masjid and Masjid Jami. When you say Masjid Jami, it means it has Friday prayer.
Okay.
So this is Masjid Jami. So this is the fifth Chinese mosque in the whole of Malaysia, and is actually copied, inspired from the great mosque of Xi'an. So if you know the great mosque in Xi'an, the Huimin.
Jadi ngopinya itu untuk apa bentuk masjidnya itu dari langsung dari
Xi'an. Over there. Yeah. So you can see some similarities and a lot of striking features that is probably taken or inspired from that same mosque.
Okay. Okay.
So without further ado, let's go inside. You can see already there is no Arabic, there is no Malay. It's, you are greeted with the Chinese 100% Chinese characters over here.
Okay.
So actually I just spoke to some of the few jemaah, the Malay people. Many people don't know that this is a mosque.
Okay.
Still, because of outside, this place looks 100%. There is no dome, there is no moon, there is no stars, there is no Arabic minaret.
Okay.
So even some of the local are actually still thinking, wondering, is it a mosque or is it
a temple?
And when they come here also, you see
the door.
Even the door is like the Chinese story, old movie, and then the words
in
are
the movie,
all
I see that
in Chinese. What is it?
真主之大.
Yeah, 真主之大. So Allahu Akbar. So now you are welcome by a Chinese courtyard. So from here you can see even this arc.
So start with here. So we see 修身养性，明理净身达真达真道. Okay, it means like we have to behave ourselves. Okay, with the teaching of Nabi Muhammad, okay, and then we spread the peace, the religion of Islam to more people. And then the second verse is 敬主爱人弃恶扬善传真理. Okay, so it's similar to the first verse, but the second verse is more on like we have to submit ourselves to the one true God, Allah. And then we have to love all the human being, no matter you are Muslim, non-Muslim, Malay, Chinese, Indian, or any races. So we love everyone, and then we hate something which is evil, and then we need to do the good deeds and spread the truth to everyone.
I saw your video. You just came back from the actual Xi'an Mosque.
Yeah. Yeah. From 1,300 years ago. Yeah.
So you can compare 1,300 years ago. But here, this mosque is not historical. So it's very new actually. But why? When we say Masjid China, so the Chinese mosque. Okay. For the local, we are now in Malaysia, okay? Malaysia is 63% Malay people. That in Malaysia, generally when say people say Muslim, it refers to the Malay people. Mm. Oh, when people go said, okay, I'm going to become Muslim, or you want to become a Malay. So there is this stigma that becoming Muslim is becoming a certain race or becoming a certain group of people. So it creates different opinions among the people. So one of the reason when we want to build the Masjid China, so one of the striking important thing that the point that we want to get across to people is China received Islam way earlier than the Malay actually. And this is one of the manifestation when you come here, oh, everything is like, look at the dome, look at this is like a pagoda. So Malay, they only know masjid in the Malay culture.
Yeah.
They don't know like how masjid looks like in China for the Chinese people. By building this mosque, it creates something that is new, like a fresh image. Oh, actually, China have lots of Muslim. Uh-huh. Chinese masjid is a masjid as well. So the design is not have to be Arabic design. So mosque can have Chinese design, can have Malay design, Indian design, Arabic design, Moorish design. A mosque, what is a mosque? So today, when we give them a tour of this place, we remind the Muslim and non-Muslim, a mosque, first and foremost, is a place to worship. So what makes it Chinese? So when you go to a restaurant, what is the difference between Chinese restaurant and normal restaurant, or mamak restaurant? So a mosque is the same, like it's all a place to eat. For mosque, it's all, when you say masjid, automatically you understand this is a place to
worship.
Pray, to worship, to pray. So what makes it Chinese? What makes it Malay? What makes it Arabic? It's the culture, the design, architecture. So in Islam, it doesn't have anything that goes against culture and architecture, as long it doesn't go against the principle of Islam. For example, we don't have like animals, we don't have idols. So for example, what is the difference between normal Chinese building with this one? So you can see here, like bamboos is a traditional identity of China, things that are in China. So when you are Chinese, it's your culture. Does it have anything against Islam? Does it say this symbol says that Allah culture is bad or something? No.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's neutral.
Betul. Jadi culture-nya tetap di situ gitu kan. Cuman orangnya itu berubah menjadi beragama Islam seperti itu, dan mereka masih tetap bisa menggunakan ya kan culture mereka itu sendiri gitu ya guys ya. Keren sih penjelasan daripada orang ini orang Melayu kan guys ya. Wow, bahasa Inggrisnya juga keren banget. Tapi kalau orang Melayu pakai bahasa Inggris itu masih ada paham-pahamnya sedikit gitu. Tapi kalau udah orang Inggris yang bercakap itu saya kayak kurang gitu. Kayak wah cepet banget sih gitu kan.
So whatever is from your own culture, when you become Islam, Islam doesn't change the culture,
bagus,
but it change the heart and it cleans the bad things. Hmm. So the good thing remains, you can keep it and then you actually improve it and you just remove the negative thing. So that is when Islam enter any cultures. So let's continue our tour. So this mosque have
jadi Islam itu ya menerima semua culture gitu ya guys ya. Yang dirubah adalah hatinya. Hatinya dirubah untuk membuang hal-hal negatif dan menjadi positif. Itu intinya, ya kan? Wow, keren sih guys penjelasannya.
Many many facilities. I remember from the video that it's actually from the main entrance all the way to the main prayer hall. It's actually a one straight line.
One line straight.
Keren.
It symbolizes oneness of God. La ilaha illallah. So here also we have Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Oh, sorry. Mei guanxi. You can see we have visitors local, whether you're Muslim or non-Muslim, everybody is welcome. This is probably in the whole Malaysia that I know, the only mosque that you can visit and you can go up the minaret.
Oh, this is
yeah, it's open. I'm not today it's locked or not. I'm not sure. Maybe
no, open.
But we can go up, and at night you can also go and enjoy the view from the top of the minaret. Some of the Chinese local, they ask why they don't have moon or the stars. So a mosque doesn't have any particular design. It can be open. In fact, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first masjid is just they put a stone over there on the corner, and then the roof is only like the leaf of the date palm trees, and that's a mosque. No, even there's no calligraphy. There is no fancy Ayatul Quran written on the wall. It can be as simple as that, as long as dedicated spot for prayer and facing the Qibla, and it's clean and people obey the rules inside the mosque. It's already a mosque. It says here, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. So it means there is no God worthy of worship. There's no God except Allah, and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And the calligraphy here, although it's Arabic, but it's actually Chinese style calligraphy. So for other people, if you ask any Muslims or Arabs, they will know this is not a typical Arabic font. So the gate reminds you, the word reminds you, and the design also remind you that there is only one God. So we have Bismillahirrahmanirrahim here. And this is, I think, same in Xi'an, the gate is like wooden, right? So this all Arabic calligraphy, the 99 names of Allah. So I will lower my voice, but the mic can pick up the voice. Salam alaikum. Okay, now we are in the main prayer hall. This main prayer hall can accommodate, including the outside, it's around 1,000 people. You can see it's not very big, but you can see the mimbar also is using the Chinese pagoda style. Still, and you can see the top, so it's very much Chinese. Even most Muslim, like Malay people, they will say, ah, this is non-Muslim symbol or something. So sometimes we cannot differentiate what is cultural, what is religious. Sometimes because it's intertwined. In life, sometimes it's intertwined. So here, you can see the Ayatul Quran surrounding the mosque. And we put Arabic, the normal one, and there is Malay, because it's Malaysia. And we have Chinese on the bottom there. Okay. Even this one is actually a mixture of a Chinese style as well.
Imam of this masjid, he can speak fluently Chinese. Wow, that's amazing. So you are Malay?
Yes, I am Malaysian. My mom is a local Chinese in Malaysia. My grandma from Hainan.
Wow. So in the future, you're going to do the khutbah in Chinese version?
Inshallah.
Inshallah.
Once per month.
I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah.
这个用了多少钱?
2,100,000 baht.
So this is also, we want to promote Chinese and Arabic calligraphy here. So inshallah, this is the plan. You can see this traditional Chinese style when they go to classes. Even when I go to the Buddhist temple here in Malaysia, most temple, they have a sitting corner and writing. Because writing calligraphy in Chinese culture, it creates calmness and it sharpens the minds, and you have to make sure that each brush and each stroke, and you learn lots of taoli, like the wisdom, hikmah. So Muslim, 当中, Muslim 的生活, 不管你去哪里, 它离不开清净寺, 清净寺是我们的, 好像我们的家一样, 我们要礼拜, 就来清净寺, 我们要学习, 也可以来清净寺. We are expecting more and more this kind of event where non-Muslim come to here to learn about Islam, and these are all this is actually the first batch of visitors in groups, so we want to train more volunteers. So if anyone who speaks Chinese and Muslims, they want to volunteer, they can come and we will train and how to share Islam to the visitors of this mosque and the Chinese mosque.
This is the cafeteria. No, they are serving lunch. I think it's the Chinese Muslim food. Oh yeah.
Asli, ini jarang banget terjadi di sini. Ini gila sih, guys. Ya di masjid ada makanan seperti ini yang komplit.
Hot pot. Also famous mitarik. Wow. Oh, this is nice.
Wow.
Fruit jelly.
Oh, 这好吃啊.
Oh, 这好吃. Yeah, you have to come to this masjid, whether you are Muslim or non-Muslim.
kalian harus datang ke masjid ini, mau Islam maupun non-Islam. Wow, keren banget sih guys ya. Beda banget sih. Asli beda banget kalau kita lihat daripada masjid-masjid lain guys ya. Ini penampakannya memang seperti halnya yang ada di Cina gitu kan, dan ada di Malaysia, mungkin satu-satunya di Malaysia seperti itu kan, dengan desain seperti itu. Atau bahkan mungkin ada yang lain lagi, tapi kalau yang seperti ini kayaknya baru ada satu kayaknya ya guys ya. Dan itu keren banget sih guys. Dan di dalamnya itu tidak hanya istilahnya kebanyakan masjid, yaitu semuanya kaligrafi dan lain sebagainya. Di sini mengajarkan ya bahwasannya ini adalah masjid dan culture-nya itu adalah Cina. Jadi Islam itu tidak merubah culture, tapi merubah hati kita, merubah yang hati kita di mana awalnya itu mungkin ya tidak cinta kepada Allah, tidak dekat kepada Allah, menjadi dekat kepada Allah dan mencintai Rasulullah, membuang hal-hal negatif dan memakai ataupun menggunakan ataupun bisa dikatakan menjaga hal-hal positif yang ada di dalam diri kita. Nah seperti itu ya guys ya. Wow, ini keren banget, ini harus patut harus kita kunjungi gitu kalau ke Malaysia gitu ya guys ya. Keren banget. Coba kita baca komentar. Tak perasan pula ada masjid nih, insyaallah I will go there. Nah itu orang Malaysia aja tak perasan dengan masjid ini ya guys ya. Makanya kita share di sini ya, sesuai daripada requestan teman-teman sekalian. Beautiful Mosque Chiang Klang. Wow, keren. Wah, cantiknya masjid nih, Malaysia tanah bertua. Wah, alhamdulillah semoga dipermudah segala urusan dunia akhirat. Semoga Allah memberkati dan merahmati kalian berdua dunia akhirat. Masya Allah, terbaik Islam untuk semua. Alhamdulillah ada masjid seperti ini, namun tak memberi faham pada umum dan memertabatkan bahasa Melayu. Kena ada tentera terjemah dalam bahasa Melayu. Iya, bisa juga. Cantik sungguh masjidnya. Nak pergi solat satu hari nanti. Boleh. Ya Allah, cantiklah. Kat situ kan ada orang Melayu juga guys ya. Bisalah istilahnya kita bercakap orang-orang dengan orang Melayu ya kan. Pastilah kan. Allah, terbaiklah guys masjidnya ini. Wuh. Dan komitmen yang disampaikan di masjid ini itu keren banget sih guys ya. Terbuka untuk umum ya, tidak tertutup. Sehingga masjid itu ya untuk sholat gitu. Sedangkan rumah kalian ini memang masjid ini seperti rumah kalian gitu kan. Tapi bedanya kalau di masjid kita sholat, kita beribadah. Kalau di rumah kita bisa istirahat. Seperti itu ya guys ya. Bahkan ada juga istilahnya masjid itu ada yang menyediakan kayak penginapan di situ. Ada juga ya guys ya. Untuk para musafir seperti itu. Itu keren banget sih guys. Wow, kayak ada hotelnya gitu masjid itu. Keren sih. Wow, terbaik lah guys ya. Yang ada di Malaysia ini kayaknya satu-satunya. Dan baru ya dibangun gitu. Baru selesai dibangun gitu ya guys ya. Terbaik. Oke guys, terima kasih sudah tengok video ini sampai selesai. Jangan lupa like, share, komen, dan subscribe. Dan saya gembira sekali hari ini karena melihat penampakan yang sangat-sangat cantik sekali. Oh, pengen banget ke situ. Terima kasih. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.